The Sabarimala shrine in South India's Kerala is set to open its gates to women of menstruating age for the first time today after the Supreme Court of India's verdict last month. The gates are scheduled to be reopened at 5:30 p.m. Indian Standard Time, but tension is mounting at Sabarimala with devotee bodies, Hindu organizations and various political outfits gearing up for a show of strength against the move to implement the Supreme Court verdict. Massive protests have gained steam over the past few days in opposition to the Supreme Court's verdict. The BJP and the RSS have been targeting the state government, calling the decision and the implementation a conspiracy to kill the tradition at the historic shrine. Women are being stopped from taking the road leading to the historic shrine. Yesterday, a woman attempted to hang herself from a tree in Kerala's capital, Thiruvananthapuram, in protest against the Supreme Court's verdict. She was saved by the locals and the police. Several women were also stopped by protesters today from taking the road leading to the historic shrine. The Travancore Devaswam Board, the body that administers the shrine, also held a meeting on the matter with all the stakeholders. The board decided to take a call on the review petition on the 19th of October. Meanwhile, Kerala's Chief Minister, Pinarayi Vijayan, has said that the government will not allow anyone to take law and order into his or her hands, adding that the government will not submit a review petition.
We are right now standing at Nilakkal, which is like a base camp 20 kilometers away from Sabarimala. It was exactly at this location, at this junction, that we see that yesterday a lot of women and a lot of Ayyappa devotees belonging to several organizations blocked buses and private vehicles. In fact, these women and devotees were checking these private vehicles and buses and looking if there were women between the age of 10 and 50. And whenever women, including journalists who were between the age 10 and 50, tried to pass beyond this point and go towards the Sabarimala temple, they were blocked yesterday and they were sent back. But now today morning, the situation is entirely different. The police are here and a large number of police personnel have been deployed. There's about 600 police personnel deployed, including women police, at this place here in Nilakkal. And the top police official here, the IG, has also clearly mentioned that the police are ready to face any eventuality, and the police is obeying the state government's line, which is to implement the law and order situation as per what the Supreme Court has said. The police is reassured that they are ready to face any eventuality, and the police has also said that they will be here to uphold the law and order situation, and nobody under any circumstances will be allowed to take law and order into their own hands. As a stark contrast, as you can see towards that side, there are several hundreds of Ayyappa devotees who are gathered here. They are shouting slogans and they are chanting in praise of Lord Ayyappa. They are of the other camp who believe that ladies between the age of 10 and 50 should not be allowed into the Sabarimala shrine. The shrine will be opened today evening from 5:30 p.m. onwards, and it is going to be a crucial day here in Kerala for the people to know whether women devotees will enter or whether law and order situation will prevail here, whether Supreme Court order will be upheld, or whether ladies will actually follow the Supreme Court order, and between the age of 10 and 50, whether these ladies will end up entering the temple.